Minnesota State Patrol says a man is lucky to be alive after a trailer hitch flew off a truck and hit his windshield.
The accident happened west of the cities in Montrose last week. State Patrol says the driver's speed and proper following distance allowed him to slow down, saving his own life. They say if the driver was hit with a 28-pound object going 55 miles an hour, the accident could have been fatal.
Most drivers really can't anticipate much either. So it really then goes back to safety on the front end, ensuring loads are secured, checking equipment regularly to make sure it's safely secured onto the vehicle.
Wow, one truck driver we spoke to said, if you see a loose load on the road, call it in or follow the driver to let them know about it. The State Patrol says if you haul anything, get it professionally checked out twice a year.
Minneapolis man charged with killing his wife and stepdaughter makes his first court appearance today. Police say Gonzalo Galvan told them he did it because they were about to leave him, also saying he had two backpacks full of money. The 48-year-old woman and her 15-year-old daughter were found dead inside their home on Friday. Police say Galvan called 911 saying he had shot them. His 7-year-old son was inside the home when it happened. That boy is now in protective custody. Galvan has been charged with 2 counts of first-degree murder. Prosecutors plan to ask the judge to set bail at $2 million when he appears in court today.
A federal lawsuit filed against the University of Minnesota Duluth. 3 former coaches say they were forced out by discrimination, hostility, and gender inequality. Basketball coach Annette Wiles resigned after 7 seasons, citing an unhealthy work environment. Jen Banford declined the school's offer to remain softball coach after the university eliminated her job as director of women's hockey operations. And UMD did not renew Shannon Miller's contract after she coached the women's hockey team to 5 national championships in her 16 years as head coach. The school cited financial reasons, but never sought to cut the coach's pay. Miller, who is gay, blames a homophobic culture perpetrated by the administration and athletic director, Josh Berlow.
There was a shift, and it was a really strong shift, and it's the most abrupt, ignorant, and rude treatment I've ever received in my entire life as a professional.
In a statement, UMD Chancellor Lenley Black said the school refutes the allegations and claims of discrimination and will aggressively defend itself in the lawsuit.
Police in Minnesota have just lost a battle to keep most videos recorded on body cameras private. This issue is far from settled. State lawmakers are still working on legislation to handle body camera footage. Police requested to temporarily keep the data private until any new law might be passed, but the commissioner for the Department of Administration rejected that request. The commissioner says under current law, the footage is public in the same way as written arrest data and police reports. A coalition of police departments argued the footage could infringe on people's privacy when they interact with officers. Transparency watchdogs say making footage private would lessen the accountability aspect of body cameras.